Behind them, they left about 50 of their planes. Most of them were scattered on the airfields in charred, twisted, and mangled wreckage. A few had crashed into the sea and were washed up on the shore. Yes, this, as indeed the whole diabolical plan of the attack, was conceived and aimed toward achieving one objective, and one objective only: to catch us off guard, smash our fleet, cripple our standing as a sea power, and put us out of business. In this it failed, but tragic and terrible was the scene of destruction. Heartbreaking, the sight of ships built to fight and die proudly, now left burning in shallow graves. Always, said President Roosevelt, always will our whole nation remember the character of the onslaught against us. A date that will live in infamy. A record for all history to read in amazement, in sorrow, in horror and disgust. Those also were President Roosevelt's words. Horror and disgust, amazement and sorrow. Sorrow, yes. Bitter, grievous, mortifying sorrow. For on this Sabbath day, 2,343 officers and enlisted men of our Army, Navy, and Marine Corps gave their young lives in the service of our country. Who were these young Americans? Let us pause for a few minutes at their hallowed graves and ask a few of them to make themselves known. Who are you, boys? Come on, speak up, some of you.
I am Robert R. Kelly, United States Army. I came from Findlay, Ohio. My parents are Mr. and Mrs. James E. Kelly. I am Alfred Aaron Rosenthal, United States Navy. I lived in Brooklyn, New York. My parents are Mr. and Mrs. Henry L. Rosenthal. I am Theodore Stephen Zabel, United States Marine Corps. My hometown is Castalia, Iowa. Those are my parents, Mr. and Mrs. Stephen Zabel. I am Moses Anderson Allen, United States Navy. I lived on a farm in Cove, North Carolina. My mother is Mrs. Abby Allen. I am James Webster Late, United States Navy. I'm from Huntington Park, California. My folks are Mr. and Mrs. William J. Late. I am Antonio Estafoya, United States Army. I live just outside of Albuquerque, New Mexico. My father and mother are Mr. and Mrs. Jesus A. Tafoya.
How does it happen that all of you sound and talk alike?
We are all alike. We are all Americans.
Long may our land be bright with freedom.
Nagasaki, Kobe, Ataro, His Excellency Premier General Hideki Tojo will report to the nation. For many years, the democracy of the United States has threatened to enslave the life of our peace-loving nation. That threat has now effectively been disposed of. I have the honor to report that our bombers have struck an annihilating blow at United States sea power. Here are the facts.
Almost immediately, the crowing began. Let's listen to the facts.
The battleship Arizona sunk and lost.
Regrettably, that's correct, Mr. Tojo.
The aircraft carrier Enterprise capsized and lost.
Incorrect. That's the old target ship Utah.
The battleship Oklahoma capsized and lost.
Capsized, but not lost. Plans are underway for righting her.
The battleships California, Nevada, and West Virginia permanently damaged beyond repair.
Temporarily damaged. But just a minute, Mr. Tojo, before you go any further with your facts, meet Captain H.N. Wallen of our Navy. He is the Bureau of Ships expert on salvage and repair. Together with hundreds of civilian technicians, machinists, welders, mechanics, engineers, many of whom were recruited from the mainland and working in complete harmony with Navy personnel, he began a 24-hour, around-the-clock job of salvage and repair that will stand forever as one of the great achievements in maritime history. Above and below the water's surface, this epic of masterful engineering went on. Captain Wallen has proved you a mighty tall storyteller, Mr. Tojo. He calls your facts by a rich Navy word, scuttlebutt. And from the very moment the attack was over, he set out to scuttle your kind of scuttlebutt. The 23-year-old California, known affectionately to our blue jackets as the Prune Barge, with her ugly wounds temporarily bound, was refloated and towed to dry dock. Similar attention was given to the 28-year-old Nevada and the 21-year-old West Virginia. Here in dry dock, in record-breaking time, they were overhauled and improved from stem to stern, from hull to peak. Now dressed in their up-to-the-minute fighting garb and raring to go, these mighty warriors and their proud crews stand out to sea. Godspeed. Saucy little gal, Captain Wallen. By George, it looks like the... Yes, it is. The mine layer, Oglala. A 4,000-ton surprise package. Given up and reported as lost, this former Fall River Line passenger ship was righted and refloated. Taken to dry dock, this small, dauntless craft was refitted and repaired. Now, spankin' new, a symbol of the fighting spirit of our men who build and man our ships, this veteran of World War I again takes up her battle station. Godspeed, old girl. Thus, war came to Hawaii, USA. The Aloha Tower, once the symbol of welcome and hospitality, now stands clad in weird war paint. No longer do luxurious liners bring vacation-bent tourists to these once happy isles. The liners, too, have gone to war. No longer is Waikiki Beach the sun-kissed playground of the Pacific. Barbed wire has changed its face, too. Now, at twilight, the city streets are empty and deserted. Blackouts start each day promptly at dusk. Well, you may crow, Mr. Tojo. You've done a good job of stabbing in the back. You've darkened our cities. You've destroyed our property. You've spilled our blood.
Our faith tells us that to all this treachery, there can be but one answer, a time-honored answer. For all they that take the sword shall perish with the sword.